What a wonderful day, everyone. Welcome to our channel. Today, we were going to discuss what is simple and compound interest. So, don't skip the vid and enjoy.
Simple interest. Simple interest is based on principal amount of a loan or deposited. Here's a simple scenario of applying simple interest.
Kyle, can you do me a favor?
Yes, Jasper. What is it?
Can I borrow 400 pesos? Because my money is not enough for the payment bill.
Yeah, sure. I can help you with that. Just make sure you pay me within 20 days with a 10% interest rate, okay?
Oh, thank you, Kyle. I promise I'll pay you. Here, Kyle. Here's the money I borrowed 2 weeks ago with a 10% interest.
Oh, thanks, Jasper.
Here's the brief explanation of how simple interest works in scene 2. In scene 2, we see Jasper and Kyle are having a deal and it involves simple interest. In simple interest, we have 5 elements. IS stands for simple interest, P stands for principal, R stands for interest rate, T stands for time, and F stands for future value or maturity value. So before we go to solution, let's first convert the interest rate into decimal form. So as you can see in sample scene, our interest rate is 10%, right? So first, we can divide it to 100, or we can move 2 times backward the decimal point to get the decimal form of 10%. Then after you do it, then it will become 0.1. So after that, let's convert the time into year. So as you can see in sample scene, our given is 20 days, so we need to convert it to year. So how do we convert it? Since the given is days, we will divide it to 365. So let's substitute it, then it will become 20 divided by 365, then it will become 0.0547945205 years. So after we convert the interest rate and the time, we can now go to solution. So first, we need to write the formula of simple interest, which is 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 equivalent to PRT. So after that, we can substitute all the given and solve it. So 400 times 0.1 times 0.54794520 is equivalent to 2.1917 8082, or in short, 2.19 is our simple interest. So after we get the simple interest, now we will going to get the maturity value. Now, what is maturity value? Maturity value is the sum of principal and simple interest. So first, let's write the formula of maturity value. F is equivalent to P plus IS. Then substitute the given and solve it. 400 plus 2.19 is equivalent to 402.19, and that's our maturity value. And that's the whole process of getting the simple interest and maturity value. Hope you learned something.
So now, let's proceed to another topic, compound interest. Compound interest is interest calculated on the initial principal, which also includes all of the previously accumulated interest from previous periods. So here's another scene with compound interest as our sample.
Thanks, Mr. Caliso. I'm Mr. Casado, and I'm here to offer you 4% interest rate for 5 years. What can you say about it?
Oh, that's a good thing to hear, but is it better than simple interest?
Yes, Mr. Caliso, because it is compounded.
Oh, that's good to hear. Okay, I'll invest 140,000 pesos. Okay, I'm expecting that. So, just like in previous topic, compound interest is just another type of interest. And here, I explain what happened to Mr. Galiso's money. First, to get the compound interest, let's get first the maturity value. The formula for maturity value is F is equivalent to P multiplied to quantity 1 plus R quantity raised to T. Then, let's substitute the given and let's start solving. But first, let's convert the percentage form of the rate into decimal form. So, the 4% will change into 0.04. So, after that, we're now going to solve. So, maturity value is equivalent to 140,000 pesos multiplied to quantity 1 plus 0.04 quantity raised to 5 is equal to 170,311.41. So our maturity value is 170,331.41. So after we get the future value, now we can get the compound interest of it. So the formula of compound interest is IC equals F minus P, or IC equals 170,331.41 minus 140,000 pesos. So our answer will be 30,331.41, and that is our compound interest for these past 5 years. And that's all I can explain. Thank you for watching and hope you learned something. Bye.
And that's all for today's video. I hope guys you understand what is simple and compound interest. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye bye.
Stronger, I'll be.